here. I'm with Aaron, and we are at the Oculus Rift booth at CES 2014 to check out your guys' new prototype. Now, you guys have so much buzz going around. You've had a lot of news. You got a new round of funding. You have John Carmack signed on full-time now. I mean, what's the most exciting thing for you guys being here at CES this year?
The most exciting thing about being here at CES is definitely showing our new prototype, the Crystal Cove prototype. I think maybe at a more macro level, we're really excited because it means we're getting closer and closer to a consumer launch. Not that we're announcing any dates here at the show.
Oh, Drat, you knew I was going to ask.
I knew you were going to ask. Leading question. But we are really excited about showing this prototype because it includes some key features of what will be the consumer product that we end up releasing.
So let's talk about what some of those key features on. I saw you guys at E3. You were the buzz of the show, which we were talking about earlier, with the prototype that you had on display there with the EVR demo that was happening on the show floor. And now you have this new one, and it definitely, just at first glance, not even putting it on and experiencing it, it looks different. So what is different about the exterior of the Crystal Cove?
Yeah, you will notice that it does look different. So this Crystal Cove prototype actually has a matrix of micro LED lights, right? There's an infrared spectrum that we are actually looking at with a camera. There's a complementary camera that's facing the unit as you wear it. And the camera knows where you are in 3D space. And as such, we're able to add new degrees of freedom of motion. So previously, you could only move your head sort of looking left and right, or yaw, and then pitch up and down, right, and then roll. But your head was really fixed at a point in space. If I was looking at a rock right here and I wanted to kind of zoom in and look closer at it, it would actually move away from me because the whole world was just stuck in one place, right? So what positional tracking does, which is one of the key components of the new Crystal Cove prototype, is it allows you to move side to side, forward and back, and then up and down. And then, of course, we still have all of that orientation tracking as well. So you can rotate along those axes of front and back. You know, basically what it means is you can move in any natural way that you want to, and the VR scene is going to render exactly as you would expect it to. So it's a one-to-one human to virtual reality motion.
That's really cool. I guess it's something you maybe don't think about as something you would need to develop for, but it makes total sense because I think we are just so used to our natural movements, we don't understand maybe what that means from a back-end development side. Are you guys showcasing a new demo to really show off these features? I'm assuming you are.
We are showing a new demo. We have amazing partners. We have Epic, who's been working with us to create some new content, and also the CCP guys, who we've been long friends with and partners in. They're one of the first launch titles that's coming out for the Oculus Rift when it does come out as a consumer product. So we have different builds for both of those that show you what it's like to actually be able to move around and explore the world very naturally. On top of the positional tracking, we actually also have another really important feature, which we refer to as low persistence. And low persistence actually solves one of the major problems that most people talk about who have experienced the Rift, and that is that the world used to sort of blur and smudge as you would turn your head, right? There's this really long sort of pixel switching time on the display panel, so it would render the right thing and then you would move your head, and for all that time you're moving your head, there would be this latency of, until the next frame refreshed, the wrong image, right? And so it basically looked like a big blur anytime you would move your head around like this. Well, now we've solved that problem. We effectively have no motion blur and no judder. So it's just a crystal clear picture as you're moving your head around, and it absolves a lot of the sickness that people had been talking about. So between positional tracking, HD display, and the low persistence, it's just a really, really comfortable experience. I think that's the number one thing that people notice immediately is it's almost like you just say, "Ah, I feel so good in here," because there's no more worries about feeling like, "Oh, something's wrong. As I move my head, it doesn't feel like it's exactly right."
Okay, well, lastly, the virtual reality scene, if you will, is becoming a little bit crowded. There's a lot of people that are trying to get into the space, and people are saying, is virtual reality the next big thing in technology? And what do you guys think about where Oculus is in this community, and how do you plan to differentiate yourselves from all of the competition out there?
You know, I think that Oculus VR is a premium brand and a premium company because we're driven by passion. All of the other factors having to do with concerns about who's doing this or who's doing that, what's our competition doing, and you know, we're not one of those companies that really talks trash about other companies. As a matter of fact, we welcome people to the VR development domain and have a lot of respect for competitors who are talking about things now because they have the foresight to understand that virtual reality really is a fundamentally new medium, and it's really exciting because it introduces a wholly different way to interact with virtual or even real worlds in the future.
Well, very cool. Well, I'm excited to test out this new demo. Thank you very much for giving me all the latest update on Oculus Rift. All of our audience out there is really excited about the progression of the prototype, and I know they want to buy them, even though we don't know when, as he stated. So let's go ahead and give it a whirl.
Awesome. Let's do it.
Okay. I'm ready to try it out.
Okay. Excellent. I don't know if you are ready. This might be kind of amazing. Okay.
Okay.
So you've had a Rift on before. You know how this works. We just sort of put it on very naturally, like ski goggles. Then I'll pull the strap back for you. And we want to make sure that it looks really clear through your eyes. So if you look right through the center of the lens in front of you, it should look just really crystal clear.
Yes.
Does that look right?
Yes, it does. Okay.
I don't know, I think maybe next CES we can work between now and then and get that to a success.
Yes, absolutely.
Awesome.
Thank you so much for showing me the demo. I think that people already are excited about this. I mean, and I think with every new time that you guys show what's the next layer and the next layer, that the excitement just keeps growing. So I know I am definitely anxious to get my hands on one, and we look forward to hearing more. And you guys are coming sometime in 2014. Just not sure when.
No release date announced yet, but we will definitely keep you posted when it happens.
Great, thank you so much. And awesome, we'll bring you guys a lot more coverage from CES right here on The Escapist.